A very good morning, class 12th. You are welcome to the channel by Seema Makhijani, and we continue with the cation analysis of group 5. Today's agenda is to identify the cation barium in the given salt sample. This is the salt that I am using, which is barium nitrate. I am not concerned about the nitrate. For nitrate, we have already done the brown ring test, which you can refer to on the channel. But today's class, we will be testing for barium, that is how to proceed up to group 5 if you are given barium as your salt. Fine, since you won't know it is barium, we will always proceed beginning from group number 0. My student Srija would be performing the experiment. Hi Srija. So she is our expert of the day to perform the experiment for the cation analysis. So let's begin. The first step is that you need to proceed for the group 0. To test that, you will first take a pinch of salt sample into a watch glass. To this, you need to add some amount of sodium hydroxide solution and smell for the presence of ammonia gas. Please smell this, Srija. No smell of ammonia. The reason why we do it like this and not in a test tube is because ammonia has got intermolecular hydrogen bonding, so it is very less volatile. So if you perform the same test in a test tube, it will take ages for the gas to be smelled easily on top of the test tube. So I would always advise that you do it in a watch glass. So zero group is absence, since the salt does not give you the gas ammonia with NaOH. Now you need to proceed for group 1, for which you require the OS. Now what is an OS? OS is nothing but your salt dissolved in water. So she'll take a small amount of original solution which was already prepared. It is just salt plus water. Take around 1 ml of OS. To this, you will add dilute HCl for group 1 cations. Use a dropper to add dilute HCl. As you can see, there is no PPT formed showing that group 1 is absent, which means the salt given to you does not have lead ions. Proceeding further, to go to group 2, now you need to pass H2S through this solution which already has an HCl in it, which means we are going to pass H2S through the OS containing HCl, hence H2S is passed in an acidic medium. So we'll proceed towards the Kipps apparatus. This three bulb apparatus is called as the Kipps apparatus, and this is the knob which you have to switch it on. First introduce the test tube into this apparatus. Introduce it further. Put it in. That's it. Now switch it on. Yeah. Switch it off again. You have to always switch it off, and let's see what happened. Did you get any PPT? No. Which means there is absence of group 2. Now what kind of PPTs are expected? It could either be a yellow PPT, which could be for arsenic or cadmium, and it could be a black PPT if it was copper. But copper salts are blue. Now since the salt was white, you can never expect a black PPT in this. Hence there is no PPT with H2S in group 2. Hence it does not have cadmium, arsenic and copper in it. We need to proceed for group 3 now. Now to proceed for the group 3, my advice is that you start afresh with the OS. So whatever original solution which was salt and water is left, take 1 ml of that original solution again to proceed for group number 3. To this you need to add a pinch of ammonium chloride solid. This is solid ammonium chloride, a pinch of it, and shake it to dissolve. This is the most important thing, because if you don't shake it to dissolve, you will mess up with your PPT of group 3. And the reason of addition of ammonium chloride is common ion effect. Please refer to the video of common ion effect for your viva in case you do not know about it. Shake it till it completely dissolves. Once this dissolves, you need to now add ammonium hydroxide to it. Use a dropper. That's the ammonium hydroxide and that's the dropper. Let's add ammonium hydroxide now. As you can see, there is no PPT observed in it, which means neither there is any jelly-like white floating PPT in it, nor do you have a reddish-brown PPT, indicates that group 3 is absent. Fine? So since there is no PPT observed in group 3, we need to proceed to group 4. At this point, you should divide your solution into two parts. One part, we will take it for group 4 of cation analysis, and the other part, we will take it for group 5 of cation analysis. So after dividing it into two parts, keep one to proceed for group 5. And the first part, I will go for the H2S passing. Now this time, what is the difference? The medium is basic, because you had added ammonium hydroxide to it in group 3, and you have to proceed for group 4 by passing H2S into this. So your H2S in group 4 is passed in the basic medium when you are trying to detect for the presence of group 4. Now in group 4 you have 4 options: nickel, cobalt, manganese and zinc. Out of these 3, nickel and cobalt are bright green and maroon colored salts respectively. Manganese is a baby pink colored salt, but my salt was absolutely white, which means the only possibility is that of zinc, which means I am expecting it to show a dirty white precipitate with H2S if at all there is any group 4. But since we very well know, we will not get a PPT with H2S, since we know it that the salt given to me is barium, and I am helping you to identify barium in an unknown salt. So for group 3, now to first part, pass H2S. So moving again to the KIPPS apparatus, just introduce the tube into your test tube. And now switch it on. This is how it's parallel to the tube. It's on and the gas is passed. And you can see there is no PPT. Let's see. As you can see, there is no black PPT showing cobalt and nickel absent. There is no buff PPT, that's pinkish peach PPT. So manganese is also absent. And neither there is any dirty white PPT, which means zinc is also absent. So group 4 is absent. Now we need to proceed for group 5 with the other part of group 3 which we were left with. Now we'll take the second part which we had kept for proceeding to group 5. Now for group 5, you need to now add to it ammonium carbonate solution, which is the group reagent for group 5. So for group 5, what is the group reagent? You had already added ammonium chloride pinch, ammonium hydroxide, no PPT, and now you are adding to it ammonium carbonate dropwise. Can you see? There is a formation of a white PPT. Continue adding, add a little more. This white PPT formation indicates the presence of group number 5, which means it either has barium ions, strontium ions or calcium ions. One of them is present in the given salt. Now to proceed, you need to dissolve the PPT in acetic acid. My advice is, in case you have a large amount of PPT, you can take half of it and then dissolve it in acetic acid. Otherwise, a large amount of acetic acid may be required. So whenever you have to dissolve a PPT, my advice is you should take a part of a PPT and check for dissolution. Okay, now we will add acetic acid to the white PPT and this should dissolve. It will require a considerable amount of acetic acid. Keep stirring, keep shaking it. Add more acetic acid. As the PPT is large in amount, you will require a large amount of acetic acid also. So you'll have to keep adding till it becomes absolutely clear. After dissolving the PPT in acetic acid, you need to divide it into 3 parts, and then these are the 3 reagents that you require. For the first part, the yellow colored solution, potassium chromate. To the second part, you will add ammonium sulfate. And to the third part, you are supposed to add ammonium oxalate. Now the agenda is, let's see what will happen. She would now divide the solution into 3 parts so that we can test for the presence of barium, strontium and calcium. This is how you will always proceed, because you will not know as to what is present in the given salt. As of now, we know it's barium, but otherwise you will not know. So you will be doing for all the 3. You will be dividing it into 3 test tubes. So she has divided her solution after dissolving it in acetic acid into 3 parts. To the first part, you are supposed to add potassium chromate, the yellow colored solution. please have a close look as to what happens. Can you see? A yellow PPT is formed. This formation of a yellow PPT indicates the presence of barium. Now, at this point, there is no need to proceed further. But there are students who do not listen and they want to proceed further to see what would happen. Otherwise, my advice is once you get barium and that is it, you report and finish. But what would happen if you use the ammonium sulfate for the second part? Let's add ammonium sulfate solution to the second part and observe what happens. To the second test tube, she is adding ammonia. Can you see? It has turned white, which means there is strontium in it. Now that is a contradiction. So if you try to do the second test in the presence of the first, it will start indicating the presence of strontium also. Now to the third part, we will add ammonium oxalate. So what we observe is that you get a white PPT in 2 and you get a yellow in 1. Now this would happen if the salt has barium. So my advice is after adding potassium chromate to the first test tube and if you get a yellow PPT, please do not proceed further, which indicates barium and that is confirmed. Also just a hint, if you are testing for cations first and you get the cation from group 1 or group 5, then make sure that you will never get sulfate and phosphate as an anion because these salts are insoluble. Which means in the presence of sulfate and phosphate, you will never get lead or group 5 cations. Now we will be doing the flame test for these barium testing. Now to perform the flame test, you need to make the paste of the given salt in concentrated HCl. So this is the salt that she's taken. And to this add 2 to 3 drops of concentrated HCl to make it into a chloride. Now there's a reason for it. You will deliberately make it into a chloride, add a little more. Because chloride salts are volatile, only then can you easily observe the flame test. Now this is the paste of the salt formed using a platinum wire. First let's check what happens to the platinum wire without the salt. You can see there is this, no color change observed. Now to this she will introduce the platinum wire into the paste and then she would introduce it to the flame. So now this application of paste is done. She will introduce it to the flame and we will observe. There is an apple green tinge that you could observe. So can you see? There is a green tinge which is observed. Go. Yeah. Can you see that green? This is the apple green that we are talking about and you get an apple green flame for barium which confirms the presence of barium cation in the given salt sample. With this, we come to the end of cation analysis. Thank you, Srija. I hope all of you are watching salt analysis and you would be able to do the barium salt in case you get it in your forthcoming board examinations. All the best. Do watch the Viva videos because your examiner will definitely be taking a Viva. And please revise your theory this year because the practicals have been done in a hush-hush due to the COVID. So your theory topics must also be strong. Fine. All the best. Do well in life. Stay healthy. Stay safe. Bye.